A challenge to the dark. Shot in the eye. Shot in the brain. Shot in the ass. Shot like a flower in the dance. Alone with everybody. The flesh covers the bone, and they put a mind in there, and sometimes a soul. And the women break faces against the walls, and the men drink too much, and nobody finds the one, but keep looking, crawling in and out of beds. Flesh covers the bone, and the flesh searches for more than flesh. There's no chance at all. We are all trapped by a singular fate. Nobody ever finds the one. The city dumps fill, the junkyards fill, the madhouses fill, the hospitals fill, the graveyards fill. Nothing else fills. As the sparrow, to give life you must take life, and as our grief falls flat and hollow upon the billy and blooded sea, I pass upon serious inward breaking shoals rimmed with white-legged, white-bellied, rotting creatures, lengthy dead and rioting against surrounding scenes. Dear child, I only did to you what the sparrow did to you. I am old when it is fashionable to be young. I cried when it was fashionable to laugh. I hated you when it would have taken less courage to love. Two flies. The flies are angry bits of life. Why are they so angry? It seems they want more. It seems almost as if they are angry that they are flies. It is not my fault. I sit in a room with them, and they taunt me with their agony. It is as if they were loose chunks of soul left out of somewhere. I try to read a paper, but they will not let me be. One seems to go in half circles, high along the wall, throwing a miserable sound upon my head. The other one, the smaller one, stays near and teases my hand, saying nothing, rising, dropping, crawling near. What God puts these lost things upon me? Other man suffers dictates of empire, tragic love. I suffer insects. I wave at the little ones, which only seems to revive his impulse to challenge. He circles swifter nearer, even making a fly sound, and one above catching the sense of the new whirling, he too, in excitement, speeds his flight, drops down suddenly in a puff of noise, and they join, encircling my hand, strumming the base of the lampshade until some man-thing in me will take no more unholiness, and I strike with the rolled-up paper, missing, striking, striking. They break in discord, some message lost between them, and I get the big one first, and he kicks on his back, flicking his legs like an angry whore. And I come down again with my paper club, and he is a smear of fly ugliness. The little one circles high now, quiet and swift, almost invisible. He does not come near my hand again.